My name's Dave Taylor, and I've been a youth pastor and a senior pastor, and in 2002, I felt God leading my family and I away from that to come join the work that was going on here in Bellwood called The Door. And we've made an after-school home for kids. We are trying to not create a program, but really a family. If you have a great home, then this is a wonderful extra place to come. If things are rough at home, or things are dysfunctional, or nobody's there for you, we want to make that place where somebody is there for you, where it's not rough, where you'll be cared for, loved on, well-fed, helped with homework, get a chance to talk about life, anything like that, anything you would normally talk to a dad about, I'm trying to be here for those kids to talk to me about. The Door was founded in 1998 by George Palmer, and he noticed that right out here in front of our building, there were kids hanging out every day on the street corner. The Door is a nonprofit 501c3 organization. We've been independent since 2004. It was founded under Frontline Ministries and then given to me in 2004 by George Palmer. We became our own independent 501c3, and we are funded by donations from individuals, churches, businesses. We don't receive any government funding, and we run a budget of about $125,000 annually, all in donations averaging around $50 or less. We publish a newsletter every month, and in that newsletter, we tell the stories of young people that we've been able to help or ways that we've seen God provide. And that keeps our supporters who pray for us, who send in a monthly donation, informed. And we also include a shopping list. What things do we need? What are we lacking in the pantry? Where do we need help? Maybe we're raising money for camp scholarships like we're in the middle of doing right now. And we communicate that. We send out 460 newsletters right now every single month to keep our supporters informed. In the future, I'd love to see more doors open in more communities. Everybody I talk to, all different places that I travel and speak, all say, I wish there was one of these in our town. And when I talk to adults, they say the same thing to me overwhelmingly. I wish there was one when I was a kid. I've known these kids since they were in seventh grade. Now they're seniors in high school. I've been here 15 years. I've been here since before some of them were born. And so that consistency of presence makes a big difference. And the rules and enforcement and respect are big issues. So many of these things fail because too many people see kids hanging out on a street corner smoking cigarettes outside or using bad language, and they don't understand what's really going on inside this place or its walls. And the newsletter and traveling and speaking about this ministry has really helped change the image of it, because people don't know. They're not inside. They don't see you help a kid with their homework. They don't see you help another kid who might be suicidal. They don't see you helping a young lady who's self-harming or any number of the other countless issues that we work with. They only see if there's some kids doing something they don't like. And so you have to communicate your story to the community. You have to communicate the need. And then you need somebody willing to give up an awful lot to take on a ministry like this. It's not a part-time job. It's not an after-school program. This has become my life, and it has to be if it's going to work.